Hey all, welcome back. In today's video, I'm going to be looking at what I believe are the best five features of FreeBSD. And if you stay to the end, I might even throw in a couple of bonuses. Thanks for joining me. Thanks for all your comments. Brilliant feedback. Really appreciate it. Don't forget to give the video a like and subscribe to the channel and click that notification bell. Lets you know when I release videos. Without further ado, let's just jump straight into it. So number one, OpenZFS 2.1. This is from 13 onwards, and it is an amazing amount of improvements seen in ZFS. Lots of them. Prefetch performance and parallel data access workloads, that's been massively improved. Scalability and reducing lock contention, reduction of the importation time of a pool. Now that's massive. I know that I had some massive problems when I upgraded from one version of FreeBSD to another, and I hadn't updated the pools in the correct order. Gave me a lot of issues. Reduced fragmentation of ZIL blocks, and an absolute ton of other stuff. The kernel module loading time has been sped up as well. Memory management is improved. The list is extensive. It's massive. And it's to their credit that they've worked on this so hard. It's just, in my view, ZFS is now the leading file system / volume manager you can get. And that's probably one of its benefits, is that it's both. There are not many out there that are. I love that I can export a pool from FreeBSD and import it into Linux. That's just mental. You couldn't do that with many file systems, that's for sure. So it's brilliant. And it goes hand in hand with the next feature. Number two, which is boot environments. Now, a boot environment is a bootable clone of a data set needed to boot the operating system. I can't tell you how much this has just saved my bacon recently. In fact, I did an upgrade from PHP 7.4 to PHP 8. Luckily, I did a boot environment, created a boot environment, and yeah, it saved my bacon because none of my apps worked. That's not fair. The main one that I need for managing spam on my mail server didn't work. It's not set up to work on PHP 8 yet, which is a bit of a problem. So I was able to roll back to a boot environment prior to me doing the PHP 8 upgrade. Bacon saved. Brilliant. Love it. I could have done it as a backup, but it's nowhere near as just Bechtel, create, name it, do your upgrades, see if it works. If it doesn't, Bechtel, activate, name of the BE, and then reboot. It's as simple as that. You don't get any simpler than that. It's just my spuds were no longer on the fire. So number three. You can't do a best top five features list without putting this in there. And it's going to be a bone of contention because it doesn't turn FreeBSD into a hypervisor, but FreeBSD jails. Amazing. FreeBSD jails are basically a chroot environment. It's not a virtual machine. It's as close to a virtual machine as you'll probably need. Unless you need to run other operating systems, of course, in which case you'll have to use some sort of hypervisor. But the chroot concept is extended, and jails just work. They are phenomenal. I have several jails set up on my servers, and I like that I can set them up, and I can just forget about them unless I need to upgrade them, which I'm about to do soon. Number four, packages, ports, and Poodry, or pauldry or powdery or however you want to say it. I don't claim to know how to say it. Again, it makes package management so simple. If you want to build stuff from source, that's what the ports tree is there for. But I would recommend, and I know I haven't done this in some of my videos, and thank you for the ones that pointed that out. You can just use the ports collection and compile everything from source and have bespoke options. It does take a while to do that because obviously you're compiling from the source, but it does give you that flexibility if you need it. Package, just the standard package management, is handled by PKG or PKGNG, as it used to be called before it was completely adopted. It's a binary way of managing your packages on FreeBSD, and it's just fantastic. You want to install something, package install Firefox, and it just does it. It pulls in all the dependencies. Yes, I know Linux has had that for a very long time, and FreeBSD has had it for a very long time. They had PKG underscore set of tools. So the new one, I say new, it's been around for a few years now, does simplify things a lot, and it gives you a lot of flexibility on what you can do with it as well. And it's just, you know, it's great. You can do a lot of the housekeeping that you would need to do. So you can do things like removing leaf packages or orphan packages. You can do all that automatically, and it's just great for that kind of thing. And then in conjunction with Powdry, however you want to say it, you can then customize your own package set, which is exactly what I've done. And it just, again, it's one of those things that just works. You put in your options files and you let it build them. Now, you can have more than one package repo. I wouldn't do that. I would just add into my line of ports that needs to be built or packages that needs to be built and do that. And I just find that this is a fantastic way of working. You get the flexibility of compiling your own ports, compiling your own packages with the amazing power of PKG. Just brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Number five, FreeBSD is a minimal install, and you install what you like on it. I class that as a feature. Don't get me wrong, I'm not going to sit here and bash Linux. That's really not what I'm about. I firmly believe you use the right tool for the right job. And Linux has a place. Why would I be testing out Linux distros if I didn't think that? I am searching for one for my desktop. But with FreeBSD, it's slightly different. And if there were all the software that I want running on that, I would jump ship. But you install what you like on FreeBSD and you make it what you want it to be. In my book, that goes a long way, a long way. If I want GNOME Shell installed, I'll install GNOME Shell. If I want KDE Plasma, I'll install KDE Plasma without any of the gumph. If I just want a basic XFCE, I'll install that. So much flexibility. So that's the five. Now, I did say that if you hang around for the whole video, I'll give you a couple of bonuses. And you can't have a best features of FreeBSD without mentioning the last two. And that's the FreeBSD handbook is phenomenal. There's been a massive push recently to get it updated. That work is still ongoing, but the handbook is amazing. If you get a chance, go through it. It's full of interesting snippets and great pieces of advice and great bits of code. It's just phenomenal. It's the first place to look when you've ever got a problem. Go straight to the handbook. And lastly, but by no means least, FreeBSD community. Again, a feature in my book. The community are fantastic, absolutely fantastic. And I include the devs, the people that email in on the lists, and YouTube creators as well. And anybody else that's creating blogs, the whole bunch, they are fantastic. They are so full of knowledge. You know, they're doing their best to put it down on paper or on a website, showing my age, or in a video form. Brilliant people. Absolute world of knowledge out there on tap just by doing a search. So that's my top five or seven, as it turns out. Sorry. Features of FreeBSD. If you find this useful, please give it a thumbs up. And while you're down there, just subscribe. Why not? Click the bell notification and you'll get notifications of when I release new videos and posts on the community tab. And for now, that'll do, I believe. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care.